Hello there. In this video, we will be talking about basics of UnetStack. UnetStack is an agent-based network stack. An agent in UnetStack is very similar to a layer in a traditional network stack, but they have more flexibility in using some of the scarce resources like energy and bandwidth to optimize an underwater network. In order to develop UnetStack agents, you need to understand some of the core concepts of UnetStack. In order to interact with UnetStack, the primary method is to use a command shell. The shell may be accessed either using a console or a TCP/IP port or even a web shell. In the last video, we have seen how to run a simple two-node network simulation and how to use the web shell to interact with the nodes. In this video, I'm going to assume that you are already running the simulation and you have access to both node A and node B. In order to see all the agents that are running in a UnetStack, you can use the command ps. That will print all the agents that are running on node A. To know more about any of the agents that are listed in there, just type the name of the agent. For example, let's try 5. And that prints out a bunch of parameters in there. If you want to know any details of any of the specific parameters, you can simply type that parameter name. If you type 5.mtu, that will print out 56. If you want to know more about any of the agents or any of the parameters of an agent, you can simply type help and 5. So you can see that there are a bunch of parameters under the physical layer agent. In this physical layer, it supports two logical channels, the control channel and the data channel. The control channel is meant for a low rate, robust data transmission, whereas the data channel is typically configured for high rate data transmission. Channel parameters work in the same way as normal parameters, but with an index. You can get details of a channel parameter by typing 5 and control or data. If you type control, it will give you the parameters of the control channel. And if you type data, it will give you the parameters of the data channel. Notice that the MTU for control is much lower than that of data. In this case, MTU is configured to be 16 bytes for control and 56 bytes for data. Even if you're using a UnetStack enabled modem, you will see a similar set of parameters, but the actual values might differ from the ones that we are using for the simulator because we are using a simulated modem in this case. Most agents support more commands than setting and getting just the parameters. In the last video, we had a glimpse of the PLVL command. Let's take a deeper look at it. We can type help PLVL, and that will tell you that this is the command that is used to get and set TX power level for all 5 channels. If you want to individually set the power level, you can actually type 5.1 of that particular channel and then use the command power level. And that will show you minus 10. If you want to change it, you can simply change by typing 5.1.powerlevel equal to minus 20. If you type PLVL again, you can see that just one of the channels power level is set to minus 20 and the others are still set to minus 10. While we can configure a modem using setting and getting of parameters or even using some of the commands, the true power of UnetStack lies in its messaging. Any agent can send a message to another agent to communicate between each other. All agents support messages that exposes their functionality. In fact, all parameters and commands are actually implemented by exchanging messages between shell agents and other agents. When a user types a parameter set or get or a command, the shell agents sends this as a message to their respective agent. Let's try this out by requesting the physical agent to transmit certain data. This can be achieved by typing 5 new TX frame request. And I can simply specify data as 1, 2, 3. Physical agent agrees to it. Once the transmission is completed, it has shown that there is a frame notification. So what we just did was requesting to the physical layer to transmit some data. And physical layer has transmitted it. But how do we know whether it has received on node B physical layer? So once there is a reception at node B, it will generate a notification. But since the shell agent on the receive side is not really looking for any incoming messages, you won't see it. In order to receive any unsolicited notification, you can subscribe to a topic of interest. You can do this by typing subscribe 5 on node B that will listen to unsolicited notifications by the 5 agent. Now, if you try this again, once the physical layer of node A transmits, you can see there are two notifications on node B, which is RX frame start notification and RX frame notification. So Rx frame start notification simply says there has been a start of a frame reception. Once it is complete and it is successfully decoded, it will print out Rx frame notification. In order to see the data, you can simply type ntf.data, and that will print out whatever data that has been transmitted from node A to node B. To quickly summarize, we looked at how the command shell of UnetStack can be accessed either through TCP port or a console or a web shell, and how to use commands and parameter set and get requests to change the way your node works. We also looked at how to set and get parameters and also use commands in over the web shell. We then looked at how to find more information about agents or any of the commands of the agents. Then we briefly looked at how messages are sent and received between agents internally inside UnetStack. And we use that to transmit and receive a simple message from node A to node B. And that's it for this video. More on Unit basics will be covered in the next video.